Are you aware of the rule of 7 in marketing? Let me state it. The rule says that in order to captivate your prospects' attention so that they become your actual clients, you need to show them your message at least 7 times for them to take an action. Imagine if you have to do it manually for each time you run a campaign. Well, this is when the Evergreen automation recipe swoops in to save your day. All you have to do is recycle your Evergreen posts at predefined time intervals over and over again for increased engagement. Another concern of a great content marketer is that they want everyone to see their content and extract all the useful information that they have to provide. A simple strategy for this is to reshare your single piece of content more than once so that it reaches out to a diverse audience. Some of the content you create never dies out and it stays relevant even years after creating it. This kind of content itself is called evergreen content, and to distribute this kind of content, you need to run evergreen campaigns to make it reach out to people in need. Now let's see how you can create an evergreen automation campaign in ContentStudio. It's a simple 3-step process. Go to Evergreen Automation Recipe and click on New Campaign button to create a campaign. Give a suitable name to your campaign and select the social channels for which you're creating this campaign. Now comes the step where you either have to create a post or bulk upload your already created posts. To bulk upload your posts via a CSV file, download the template file in your system and add your posts in the file. You can upload 4 types of posts in the system: a text-only post, text with an image post, text with link preview post, and text with custom image on link preview post. Let me explain each type of post and how to fill the file for each post respectively. For the text-only post, you need to add the text in the first column of the file, and that's it. For the text with image post, you need to add irrelevant text to your post and a proper URL of the image that's placed publicly anywhere on the web. Now, sometimes you need to share the curated posts on your channels. For this, you need to understand the next 2 options. If you want to share a link and add some caption to it, you could create a 3rd type of post by adding your own text in the first field and adding the URL of any type of content that you want to share in the 3rd field. And sometimes you don't like the thumbnails of the curated posts. For this, you can share the link of the curated post in the 3rd field and add a link to your custom image in the 2nd field. And of course, some text for your caption in the message field. Once you're done creating your CSV file, upload it to the system. The system may take a little while to go through each one of your posts and process them all. Once your posts are processed, all these posts will appear linearly for you to approve them or edit them. If you don't want to share a single post repeatedly with the same caption, you can also use our variation feature to either manually feed your own variations, or if you're not up for it, you could also use system-generated variations. Our system will smartly traverse through your article and intelligently create a caption for you. The number of variations the system offers for you would depend upon the length of the article that you're sharing. However, this feature doesn't work for text-only posts. You can also add a post manually if you miss out on creating a post through your CSV file. Once you're done finalizing all types of posts, click on Next and select a schedule for all your posts. You could either create custom time slots for your posts or choose to automate your posts at regular intervals. Your posts and your schedules have been created, and now you need to create a schedule for this campaign. You could either choose to run the campaign continuously right away or set a start and end time of your campaign yourself. And lastly, you can also add a cycle gap between your posts so that they don't seem like spammed posts. Or ignore this option, it totally depends on the nature of your campaign. However, if you do choose a gap period, the number of days you choose as your gap will be the gap added between your cycle. For example, if you have 6 posts in one cycle and you want to repeatedly share them with a cycle gap of 2 days, after one cycle is completed, which includes publishing 6 posts on your social channels, The second cycle will not repeat until your gap time is completed, which is 2 days. So the next rotation will start after 2 days. And this is how your Evergreen campaign is created, which totally automates your social posts. If you want to monitor all the posts scheduled in your Evergreen campaigns, go to Planner and apply the filter for Evergreen Automation Posts. Your posts will appear with respect to each social channel, and you can see the current status of each of your posts. Remember, you can always edit or remove your posts in the Planner too.